Experiments with Water Part 2. Let's see some magic experiments. Children, in our last video, that is part 1, we have seen experiments regarding float and sink. Yes or no? Shall we continue with that with few more magic experiments? Shall we start? Experiment with water and egg. First, we will take a glass of fresh water and in that we will try to put an egg. Okay. When we put the egg in the glass of fresh water, what happened? The egg got sinked in the water. The egg go to the bottom. That is, the egg sinks in the water of fresh, in a glass of fresh water. Now, if we take a glass of salt water, that is, we have put few salt in that, if we have put a salt in that glass of water, and now if we try to put the egg in that, see what's happening? It is floating. So, what we have seen now, if we are putting the egg in a glass of fresh water, it is sinking, and if we are putting the egg in a glass of salt water, then it is floating. Now, we'll do another experiment with water and lemon. Now, in a glass of water, if we put a lemon, what is happening? The lemon is getting sink in the water, that is going to the bottom. The lemon sinks. Now, if we add few salt in that, now we add salt in that and mix it, then see what happens. The lemon comes to the top and it starts floating. Now, did you watch the experiment carefully? Yes? And are you all confused? What we saw in those experiments, that when we have taken the egg, put it in the fresh water, the egg is sinking. But in salty water, the egg is floating. Similarly, lemon also sinks in the fresh water and floats in the salty water. Now, can you guess why this is happening? It's one is a fresh water, normal water. In the other glass, in that we have put few salt, that's it. But it is floating. Can you guess why this has happened? As in our last video, we learned why objects float or sink. So now we have seen why objects float or sink. What we said, if the weight of the object, whatever object we are putting, is more than the weight of displaced water. Displaced water means what we said, the place, the if we put some object in the water, it needs some space in that. So that space occupied by the object, that water which is displaced, is known as displaced water. Weight of the object is more than the weight of displaced water, then what happens? The objects get sink. And if weight of the object is less than the weight of the displaced water, then it floats. So, when we put salt in the water, what is happening? The water becomes very heavy, that is denser. So, the objects float on water. Understood, ma? When we have taken an egg and we have put it in the normal water, the weight of the egg is more than the water displaced. So, it got sinked. But when we put salt in the water, water becomes denser, that is, the water is becoming heavy. So that's why when we put the egg in that salty water, egg or lemon in the salty water, the weight of that lemon or egg is becoming less than the weight of the displaced water. That's why it is floating. Okay. Now, there's a sea called Dead Sea. We know all oceans and seas have salty water. Yes or no? How is the sea's water? Can you drink that? It will be very salty. But the saltiest of all is the Dead Sea. It is also called as Salt Sea. It is situated between Israel and Jordan in southwestern Asia. Do you know how salty it is? Can you guess how salty it is? If you take 1 liter of water, the salt will be nearly 300 grams in that. See here, Even if a person who does not know to swim, they will not drown in this sea. They will float as if lying down in it. See, the image is given for you, isn't it? A boy is sleeping on that water. So he is floating on the water. So as the water is very heavy, just now I told you, na, when we put salt in the water, what happens? It becomes denser. That is, it becomes, water becomes very heavy. So when water is very heavy, whatever object you are putting, weight of that object will be less than the water displaced. So what happened? Definitely we will float on that water. We will not get sink in the water. That's why as this Dead Sea water, it is very salty. That's why if anyone who does not even know the swimming, if he goes into the water, he will never sink in that water. Now let's do few more experiments. Experiment with salt, sugar and sand. Now I'll take 3 glasses of fresh water, and in the front I've kept few bowls. As I know, what are they? The first one is salt, the second one is sugar, and the third one is sand or soil. Whatever you want, you can take it. Okay. Now first we will do the salt experiment. Okay. Now in the fresh water glass, if I put salt, okay, a spoon of salt, and stir it, that it's mix it, see what is happening? The salt is getting mixed in that, and the salt is dissolving in the water. That is, pani mein gul jata hai. So when we mix salt in the fresh glass of water, what is happening? It is getting dissolved in the water. Now next we will do the sugar experiment. Now similarly, I'll take a spoon of sugar and mix it in the water. So what happens when I stir? Stir means mixing, shaking the spoon in that glass. When I stir that sugar in the glass of water, it is also getting dissolved in the water. That is mixing in the water. Now we will try with the sand. That is, now we will do the sand experiment. Now when I take a spoon of sand or soil and mix it in the water, see what is happening? When we put the soil in the water and stir it, the soil settles at the bottom. That is, can you see here? The soil is coming and settling in the bottom, and the water of the color is changing. That is, it is becoming the muddy color. Okay children, now soluble and insoluble materials. To check the solubility of substances, we took 3 glasses of water, a spoon, some salt, sugar and sand. Yes or no? Last experiment we took 3 glasses of water, and what we did? We took salt, sugar and sand. When we added a spoon of salt to the first glass and stir it, stir means what? Mixing. Stir it, the salt completely dissolved. Salt got dissolved. Dissolved means totally mixed in the water. No. Now next, when we added a spoon of sugar in the second glass, what did we observe? The sugar also dissolves in water. Finally, when we added the soil to the last glass of water, what happened? Did the soil or sand which you are putting, is it getting dissolved? Mix ho ja raha kya pani mein? No. What happens? The soil settles at the bottom of the glass. Settles at the bottom of the glass means the soil or sand which you are putting, it will go to the bottom of the glass or bowl which you take, and the color of the water also changes. It becomes a muddy color. So materials like salt and sugar will dissolve in water are called soluble. So understood what is the meaning of soluble? The materials which we are putting in the water, like salt, sugar, whatever, if it is dissolving, pura gul ja raha hai pani mein, mix ho ja raha hai, then we call it as soluble, and they dissolve completely in water. Whereas substances that do not dissolve in water, like soil, are called insoluble materials. Soluble materials are the things which get dissolved in the water, and insoluble materials are the things which do not dissolve in the water. Now things can be dissolved quickly by. Now, how can we dissolve quickly? Few things can dissolve easily, but few things require to be stirred more. Yes or no? So we'll see how things can be dissolved quickly. One, stirring it continuously. Stirring means mixing with a spoon or spatula or anything, stirring it continuously and fastly. And the next one is heating up the liquid. When you heat up the liquid, then it gets dissolved quickly. And one more is making of the things to be powdered. So for example, we have taken sugar. Sugar's crystal shapes, yes or no? So it takes time, you need to stir it more, but if you powder it and put it, see, it get dissolves fastly. Understood, children? Now things will make a tabular column of all the things which we have seen. Now things, did it dissolve or not? What happened after keeping it for 2 minutes? Now first, salt, did the salt dissolve in water or not? Yes, it dissolved. And what happened after, if you keep it for some time, the salt got mixed well with the water. It totally gets mixed well with the water. See the image which is given here, I am putting the salt in that. So when we put the salt and mix it, stir it, what happens? It gets dissolved in the water. Next, soil. Did the soil got dissolved in the experiment which we have seen before? No, the soil does not get mixed with the water. Instead, it settled down at the bottom. Instead of that, what happens? It settles down at the bottom. See what is happening? The soil or sand which you have put, it's settling down at the bottom, and the water of the color also changes to muddy. Now next, chalk powder. You all know chalk powder? Chalk piece which your teacher uses to write, if you try to make it into a powder and put it, that will also not dissolve. Chalk powder also settles down at the bottom by turning the water into white color. The powder which is there, the powder settles at the bottom and the color of the water also changes to white color. Now 1 spoon of milk. One spoon of milk, if you put it in a glass of water, it will definitely get dissolved. But what happens? The color of the water changes. So no, that whitish color we will get it. See this, when we put in that, what happens? It looks like a milk color. Oil. When we pour oil in a glass of water, oil does not dissolve and it does not get mixed with water. Instead of that, what happens? It is floated on. See, can you see here what is happening? The oil comes onto the top, it floats onto the floats on the top, but it does not get dissolved in the water. Now let's see a few questions related to our experiments. Now could you see the salt after it dissolved in water? If no, why? Salt when dissolved in water cannot be seen since it is soluble in water. Yes or no? Salt when dissolved in water, what it happens? Can we see after it gets? No, because it gets dissolved in the water, because it is soluble in the water. Now, does that mean that now the water does not have salt? If it has, then where is the salt? Now, when we are saying that the salt we cannot see because it is getting dissolved. So, does that mean that salt does not have salt? No, it does not mean that water does not have salt. The salt is dissolved in the water. After dissolving the water, you just drink that water, a sip of that water, you will feel that saltiness. Yes or no? The salt is just dissolving in the water, but the it doesn't mean that the water does not have salt. What difference did you see in the water with salt and water with chalk powder after keeping for some time? So if we keep it for some time in a glass of chalk powder water and a glass of salt water, what is different? What we saw, salt is getting dissolved in the water. Yes or no? Salt is getting totally dissolved in the water and it's look transparent only. Transparent means it is visible. While the chalk powder, what we said, chalk powder does not dissolve in water, but instead of that, what happens? The chalk powder settles at the bottom. Niche chala jata hai, like in soil where it went down and changed the color. Similarly, the chalk powder will also become like that. Now, which of the two would you be able to separate from the water by straining with a cloth, salt or chalk powder? So now they are asking you which of the two, that is whether salt or chalk powder can be separate. After putting it in the glass of water, if we put salt in the water and stir it, can we separate the salt from that? No. So salt can be separated or chalk powder can be separated by straining. Straining means what? After your mother prepares tea, doesn't she strain that? And so now we get a strainer. In a strainer, we can separate chalk powder, because chalk powder, what is happening? It is settling at the bottom. That's why we can separate the chalk powder by straining with a cloth, since it does not get dissolved. Salt get dissolved in water, hence we cannot strain it. See, here you can see the picture of the strainer. This is the picture of a strainer. Now we have used cloth because they are asking straining with the cloth. So we have kept a cloth, and if we pour that water in that, what happens? That white part of the chalk remains in the cloth. Do you think the oil got dissolved in water? Why do you think so? Does the oil gets dissolved in water? Oil is heavy, so it doesn't dissolve in the water. Instead of it just floats on top of the water. Racing drops. When we put 2 drops of oil on the lid, next to that put 2 drops of water and 2 drops of sugar solution. Sugar solution is nothing but mixing little bit of water, take little bit of sugar, mix it, stir it and mix it nicely. Then that solution which we get is only sugar solution. Now tilt the lid. We see some drops slid down quickly while some are left behind. So what are they saying in this? When we take a lid, lid means you can take any tiffin box lid or any lid. Okay, if you take any lid and on that they are asking you to drop 2 drops of oil. See, here you can see they have put 2 drops of oil, 2 drops of water and 2 drops of sugar solution. Okay, if we keep and tilt, tilt means bend it in this way. As the girl is catching in this way, she has tilted it, that is bent a little. Okay, tilt the lid, then what do we see? They are asking us that they are saying that few drops come quickly and others are left behind. So guess which drop went ahead. Why did it slide faster? Now they are asking which came first. Okay, 3. We have kept a running race for the 3. Okay, 1 is for the oil, 1 is for water and the other 1 is sugar solution. So they are asking which will come first down and why it came down. Okay, now drops of water slide faster than oil drops or sugar solution, since both oil and sugar solution are thicker than that of water and get stuck to the box by making it difficult to slide. So understand, when water comes down fast, ma, if you keep a running race for those 3, which will come fast? The water is coming fast than oil and the sugar solution. I already told you what is sugar solution. Mixing water and sugar together, mix it properly, then the solution which you receive is sugar solution. Why? Because oil and the sugar solution, how it will be? It will be little thicker. So now you touch your oil in your half finger, in 2 fingers, and see how the oil would be, how the sugar solution will be and how the water will be. Water will be very light, whereas oil and sugar solution will be very thicker. So what happens? The water comes fast down than both. So and as it is very thicker and it is very sticky also, you keep it between your 2 fingers and see, sugar solution and oil is sticky. So that's why what happens, it will stick to that plastic lid. Okay children, now if you put some water to boil on the stove for making tea and forget about it, when we remember and come to check, what do we find out? We find that very little water is left in the pan. For example, if your mother is cooking, is preparing some tea, okay, she has kept water to boil. For tea, she will keep water to boil, na. So when she kept boil and she forgot, you sat and you were talking with her, so she forgot about that. So when she goes back to the kitchen and see, the water became very less. Do you know why that happened? Yes, see, I'm giving you an example. This is water which is boiling. Are you able to see something is happening here? Yes, it's evaporating. What do we call it as? This process by which water gets converted from liquid to the vapor form is known as evaporation. So when it is boiling, the liquid is there. Nama, liquid means water which is there. It is converting to vapor. You are able to see vapors? Yes, vapors. And this process of converting the liquid to vapor is called evaporation. Already in your rain cycle and all, we learned about evaporation in your third and fourth classes, no? So that only when we boil, the water boils and some water gets evaporated. That's why water is very less. You can try this experiment, ma. You take two glasses of take a glass of water, okay? Otherwise take two glasses of water. One glass of water you keep it inside, let the level of the water be same, pour same amount of water. One you keep it inside and one you keep it in the sun, okay? When it is very heat, keep it in the sun for 3 hours, then you check it, what happened? The water reduces in that due to evaporation, and it should be heat, ma. Sun's rays should be there, it should be heat, then only it gets evaporated. Understood what is evaporation? Now think, where did the water go? Now we have seen that the water is going, where did the water go? The water got evaporated, hence remains less in the pan. Just now I told you what is evaporation. Changing of the liquid to vapor form is called evaporation. Now next, why did, in our last lesson we saw in near mango's lesson, why did Chitti Babu and Chinna Babu keep their mango jelly in the sun? In that lesson we saw that Chitti Babu and Chinna Babu, the two guys who prepared mango jelly, remember Mamadi Tandra, they kept it in the sun. Why? They kept their mango gel in the sun so that water in it gets evaporated. So they keep it in the sun so that the water which is left out in that will get evaporated. Next, at your house, what things are made by drying in the sun? We can prepare papad, pickles, mango jelly by drying in the sun. Do you know, children, why this is made like this? Because when no water is there, water is evaporated. You saw mango pickle also, they keep it in the sun. Tomatoes they cut for pickles and keep it in the sun, because the water get evaporated from that, and that will not spoil. Dandi March. This incident took place in 1930, before India became independent. For many years, the British had made a law that did not allow people to make salt themselves. So they also put heavy tax on salt, by which our people were not able to prepare salt even that is required at home. Can we stay without salt? Tell me, can you have food without salt? Definitely in curries and all, if salt is not there, will you eat? We will not eat. So then Gandhiji with several other people, he went on a yatra. Yatra means what? Long walk from Ahmedabad to Dandi seashore in Gujarat. Dandi seashore in Gujarat to protest against this law. Okay, now do you know how the salt is made? First, the sea water is collected in shallow beds dug in the sand. Water is allowed to dry in the sun. After the water dries, the salt remains on the ground. Okay, do you want to see what it is? This is the shallow beds, ma. You can see this near the seashore. See, you can see the water here near the seashores only. This is made like the shallow beds. Shallow beds means the mud is removed from here and it's made like a bed, and in that the water is stored. Okay, when like this in the shallow beds, when the sea water is stored, and how is sea water? Tell me, it is salty. And when the water is stored like this in the beds and it is left for few days, so that what happens? Just now I told you, when you leave water in the sun, what happens? Water evaporates. Yes or no? Due to sun's heat, what happens? the water gets evaporates. After it get evaporates, what is left out? The crystallized, that is the fat salt would be there, na? It would be there in your house. You can ask your mother for that to show. Okay, that is left out, which is again processed, and then you will get fine salt at your home, which you are using. Okay, children, did you understand the meaning of evaporation and how this plays important role in making salt? Yes, good. Thank you.